Today we're going to look at these Knipex electronic super nips XL.
It'll be the first time I've got anywhere near them.
Yeah, that's because electronic, Gary, it's not normally the world you live in. You live in the world of chunky copper cables and traditional side cutters. However, we are seeing more and more electronics creep in to the electrical industry, and we think these will rapidly become an electrician's toolbox essential.
Okay, let's compare them to those traditional side cutters, and you show me some of the differences.
Okay, so probably the key difference when you look at electronic side cutters is this beveled edge. So here's your traditional chunky copper cable cutters that probably everyone has in the toolbox, and you'll see that beveled edge down there. Whereas if you look at these super nips, the side cutters, this is completely flush between the two sides.
And what's the advantage of having that then?
So normally in the electronic environment, this is designed to get close to circuit boards.
Right.
However, when we think about electricians doing things, so let's just take a cable tie. And again, we'll flush up the edge of the cable tie. I'm going to slice the excess off there, and you can see I've got a nice smooth edge.
Right, okay, yeah, that is really close.
Right in there, but if I compare that with the traditional side cutters and that beveled edge.
You think you're going to be a bit further away?
So, there you go. So,
oh yeah, you can see that overhang of the plastic.
So not massive, but enough to catch your finger and in some cases yield some of the red stuff. So these are great. So we've picked the 140 version. I know we love a part number, so this is the 7861140, so the 140 being the length of the cutter, 15 millimeters longer than the standard one.
Right, okay.
And so we think that's probably the best for an electrician who wants to use them for other purposes than just slicing plastic cable ties. The other advantage being that this will cut 1.4 millimeter steel wire.
Okay, yeah.
And we've got some applications we've also used it on, Gary, haven't we?
Yeah, we have. Is it me, or is it difficult with a normal pair of side cutters to remove that piece of string?
Yeah, it is, and it can be difficult even to cut very fine wires, and that's what we've got here in this security cable. Now we're just going to demonstrate how fine you can cut, Guy. Given this a haircut, what's the biggest challenge here, Gary?
My eyes are the camera, and your eyes trying to see what you're doing.
Yeah, so once you've actually found the individual strands, it's amazing how precise you can trim them. Don't know why you'd need to give one a haircut, but if you did, you can. Again, just effortlessly cutting through the actual cable itself. And then let's look at that other application. We know what happens when you leave a nice sharp cable tie end.
Yeah, it's like almost like a paper cut, and it's the deepest cut you ever have if it's
and
a sharp end.
That flush edge on that cutter comes in.
Okay. Another little trick we've done before, and we found this a little bit more difficult than this is going to look. Look how easy that is.
Yeah, so again, you can cut right up to the surface on something if you try to cut to a template.
Well, it wouldn't be an eFIXX video if we didn't at some point get the ferrules and the ferrule crimping tool out. But there's always that debate about how much of the conductors we should leave poking through the ferrule.
Yeah, we usually say between 0.1 and 1 millimetre, depending on the conductor size. I'm crimping up here some 6 millimetre HO7 rubber cable. But even regardless of where you are on how long that should be, you often have to trim it because of the cable itself has been bent, not the strands won't all be the same length, so just nipping them off there.
Yeah, and there's something really satisfying about just trimming those back. They look beautiful, don't they? Just there they are, almost flush with the end of the ferrule.
So at the other end of the scale, we've got some steel cable ties here. We just want to take the end off before it takes the end of your finger off.
Yeah, and it's really important that we get it nice and flush on any sharp edges, and obviously how important it is to support cable systems to prevent premature collapsing with a metal tie.
So it does a good job at that. So this will handle up to a 1.4 millimeter steel cable. And here's the other one. Obviously we've made a mistake, or we need to reroute that cable. How do you remove the ties?
And often then you go in and you're sort of wrenching around trying to snap them, but it cuts effortlessly.
Yeah, and with that small head, you can really easily get in there. Here's another common application we've seen, our favourite LED strip. So just using them there to part some ribbon cable apart. And then you can use them for stripping if you're adept with your wrists. You may want to use the Preki strip. That's a favourite of ours here at eFIXX. So here's another common application, cutting some LED strip.
And again, it's trying to get it perfectly between the two points, so that's cut it absolutely spot on before we obviously solder these ends up. They look a little bit long to me.
Yeah, so I always tend to make them a bit long, then just trim them back to the size of the pads on the LED strip we're going to attach to.
Another feature I notice about these Knipex Super Nips XL is the fact that the handles are sprung compared to those traditional side cutters.
Yeah, so sprung loaded. Yeah, so here's our traditional side cutters, and they flop around. But these for repetitive operations, these are very, very light in the hand. you're not going to get any RSI through using these all day.
And it also states on there, does it, the diameters of cables that they can cut, is that right?
It is, yep, so alongside, so as I said earlier, we've got the 1.4mm steel and also 2.1mm copper, and that's diameter, not cross-sectional area.
Okay. Yeah, and having that sprung loaded pipe, you know, obviously saving the risk, doesn't it? So when we're working in those sort of environments that we've shown, that fine precision stuff that you're quite right, that I should be let nowhere near, should I, Gordon?
No, but yeah, if you're installing data, and obviously data is creeping into everything from the EV chargers through to obviously solar panels and obviously those that upsell into a rewire, everyone should be doing a bit of data. We think these are essential, and you will see the difference in you know, those terminations a lot easier when you've got some of these. But what do you think?
Yeah, as always, we're interested in your feedback. These Super Knips XLs, have you got a set? Do you think they're brilliant? Have you got something else that you want to throw into the mix that Knipex have got? Leave all those comments below and we'll try and get back to as many as we can.
And of course, I will leave a link in the description where you can go off and see how much they are.
Yeah, I'd like a set of these.
Not having mine.